My name is Elizabeth Moran, and my work in From Generation to Generation is called Record of Cherry Road and George Lucie Cary, 2016, Strange but True. Record of Cherry Road is a project I've been working on for many years now, collaboratively with my mother, my uncle, and my aunt, three siblings who grew up in a haunted house outside of Memphis, Tennessee. And so together we are looking at their archive of photographs, typed accounts, and magazine clippings of all the things that happened to them growing up in the house, like footsteps going up and down the stairs every night and the radio being turned on full blast, as well as going back and re-documenting these sites and recording their accounts today as they remember them some 50 years later. Well, I have known these stories as long as I can remember, but it wasn't until my Uncle Beau, George, told us that he was going to take up ghost hunting that I first thought that this could potentially be something I would want to do with him and turn into a project. So a few years went by, and then finally I called him up in Memphis and said, you know, would you mind if I tagged along on a few ghost hunts? And of course he said yes, which was great. And so I started going to Memphis very regularly. And at first just started working with him and his team and learning their tools and the different ways that they visualize paranormal activity. The work really transitioned when my mother gave me her record of Cherry Road, which I did not know existed until I started this project. And so prior to that, I was very much in the mode of this rational way of trying to seek out evidence of spirits and using these tools and these particular laser grids and wavelengths that supposedly ghost hunters believe reveal human energies that still exist. But then in receiving my mother's record, I was able to see it from her perspective, and she was the youngest of the three of them and was a little girl when they moved into the house. And so her record was more experiential evidence and these typed up documents of everything that happened to her or anyone who ever visited the house, and these amazing hand-drawn maps, architectural maps of every floor of the house and the way the footsteps moved. But then also newspaper clippings and magazines from libraries and anything she could get her hands on, looking at ghost stories around the world and comparing what she was experiencing with what people have experienced across time and across continents. And I first started recording them at our reunion in 2011, and then I recorded them again in 2014. So what you're hearing in the gallery is 2016, the most recent. And what I love about them collectively remembering the house and the stories is that they remember things together. There's a detail that maybe someone hadn't mentioned in many, many years, and then it comes up for the first time, and then that sparks another memory that we haven't heard maybe even ever before. So it is this living memory, and so the 2016 version is the story as it was this year. They fully know how silly these stories sound. In the audio piece, you hear them laughing, you know, both at the stories themselves, because some of them are just so funny, but then also laughing because they know it sounds kind of crazy. But, you know, that's where I love my mom's chapter title, Strange But True. It's, they did experience something that cannot be easily explained. And so for them, it was this significant experience. And it wasn't scary, but it was just this strange, mysterious thing that tied them together. And now in passing down the stories has sort of tied our whole family together. I mean, we all look forward to that part of the family reunion where we all come together and hear the stories. And even my little cousins now, the grandkids, the third generation, they all love ghosts. I mean, it's really become this family tradition in that way.